Hey everybody, welcome to Vacuum Wars and to our test and review of the brand new Roborock S5 Max. We've tested every robot vacuum from Roborock so far, but I think the S5 Max might be their best one yet, and this video will explain why I think that. So links in the description and let's get started. Though I plan on doing a full video showing all the differences with the current Roborock lineup next week, the main thing to know for our purposes today is that the S5 Max is more than just an update from the previous S5 version, which was one of our favorite robot vacuums when it came out a few years ago. But Roborock has essentially released a new generation of robot vacuums since then with the S6, the S4, and now with the S5 Max. So in many ways, this release is intended to bring their very popular S5 model into the next generation with updated hardware and software. The newer Roborocks have a much larger 32-bit quad-core processor. This bigger brain helps them in a number of ways, but especially with navigation, which we'll talk more about later on. These three newer ones also have upgraded side brushes, which are made out of materials that are less prone to wear, as well as upgraded main brushes, which have more bristles and are supposedly better with resisting pet hair tangles. But the main upgrades from the older S5 to the next generation is with the software, and there are a lot of new features to play around with in the app, which again, we'll talk more about later. But now let's get into some specific issues because there are a lot of differences between the S5 Max and its new generation counterparts. First things first, the S5 Max did its main job of picking up debris off of hard floors and carpets extremely well in our tests. I've always praised Roborock robot vacuums for their clean pickup ability, meaning that their brushes work well together and just pick up various types and sizes of debris very cleanly without scattering debris with its side brush or blowing it around with its exhaust. And it seemed to me that the S5 Max was better than any I've seen to date with pure pickup ability. I tested it on its max power and its so-called balanced power mode, and in both cases it was really impressive. It was possibly the best sand pickup on hard floors I've seen yet, which is not very easy to do or very common, especially in a lower power setting. On carpets it had the same great pickup ability for all types and sizes of debris that I tested, and I did not notice any of the side brush stalling problems that I saw with some of the others, like with the S6. On the carpet deep clean test, where we embed 100 grams of sand into medium pile carpet and weigh the dust bins after 5 minutes, it scored an above average 78, basically the same score as the older S5 and a little better than the S6. Roborock has always done well with our pet hair tangle test, and the S5 Max was no different. It was able to resist 100% of the 1 gram of 5 inch hair on max power, which was impressive, though increasing either the amount or length of hair from that point will cause some light tangles, but even so, it was well above average for robot vacuums in general. We tested its power in a number of ways and found that it had a touch more airflow than the older S5 as well as the S6, though the S6 probably has less power by design to get better battery life numbers, which we talked about in the full review of the S6. It did a little better with the crevice pickup test than those other two as well, getting most of the debris from the 1/8 inch crevice and a touch more from the 1/4 inch crevice than the others did. The S5 Max has a much bigger dust bin than the old S5 and the S6 at 640 milliliters. It's the same size as the S4, which I think is a major plus, and it's especially impressive when you consider that they still made room for the new large water tank for mopping, which we'll discuss later. With navigation, it was as good or better than any robot vacuum I've tested to date. It uses LiDAR, a spinning invisible laser to map out your house, and it created a complete map on its first run in our case. As previously mentioned, its new quad-core processor makes it really efficient with navigation, and we saw the same lightning-fast speeds at covering both our small and large room tests that we saw with the S4 and S6, all while achieving near-perfect coverage, including places like under chairs and other nooks and crannies. In general, its navigation and obstacle avoidance was really good. It also had higher than normal climbing ability, and it did pretty well with not disturbing small mats as well. Like the older S5, the S5 Max also has virtual walls or no-go lines where you draw lines and or boxes on the map in the app, which keeps the robot from going where you don't want it to go. Subscribers of this channel know how much I love this feature, and I found it to be pitch perfect in terms of accuracy with the S5 Max. Like the other next generation Roborocks, the S5 Max has some app upgrades like the room select feature, which is where after it creates a map, you can divide and name the rooms in your house so that you can tell it to clean certain rooms and not others, which means that you can really customize your scheduled cleanings. Like you could could say, on Mondays, vacuum the kitchen and living room only on max power at 8 a.m. or any number of variations. And that brings us to the main difference between the S5 Max and all the other Roborocks, the new mopping features. So while the older S5 as well as the S6 and some others have had mopping attachments, the S5 Max represents a totally new mopping design. The older mops were basically small capacity tanks with a pad that just attached to the bottom of the robot. They functioned essentially using gravity, where the water slowly seeped into the mopping pad at a fixed rate. The S5 Max is the first Roborock to include a separate detachable electric water tank, which can hold quite a bit more water than the previous model. This is combined with a very similar mopping pad attachment, but instead of it operating purely by gravity, it now has an electronically controlled water dispenser which can be adjusted in the app. We tested this with dried on coffee, grape, and vegetable juice stains and found that it was quite a bit better than previous Roborocks that we've tested. It got the easier coffee stains in the first pass, though the much tougher grape and vegetable juice stains took two full runs to clear. These are really hard tests for robot mop combos. They're even kind of hard tests for straight up electric mops, but I would say that the S5 Max is the best robot mop combo I've seen in terms of pure mopping ability so far. The new software features for mopping were also a major plus, mainly that in addition to the no-go lines that you set up, you can also set up no mop zones, which will only be recognized if you have the mop pad attached. I didn't realize how helpful it would be to have separate keep-out zones just for mopping until these features started to show up with the S6, but it really does make mopping so much more useful, and it's something that I'm likely to actually use. The Roborock S5 has the same amazing 3-hour battery life on low power that we saw with the original S5, and it's still one of the best battery life numbers in the industry. So, honestly, I couldn't find a single thing not to like about the S5 Max, other than the fact that it's a bit pricey. Though all things considered, it's pretty reasonable for what you're getting. It's a significant upgrade from the S5, it's nearly perfect with its pickup ability and navigation, and all the app and mop features are some of the best, if not the best, in the industry. So, links in the description, and be sure to subscribe to Vacuum Wars before you leave. Thanks for watching.